Hello, I'm Congressman Marlin Stutzman, a fourth-generation farmer, and I have the honor of serving Indiana's 3rd District. Across the country, from small towns to inner cities, too many of our fellow citizens feel like the American dream is out of reach. Our economy just isn't creating enough jobs. More than 10 million Americans are unemployed. Last month, roughly 350,000 Americans, a little more than the population of Tampa, Florida, stopped looking for work. Healthcare premiums have gone up, and millions of families have lost their insurance because of the new healthcare law. But Americans don't need to read another jobs report to know that our economy is struggling. For the past 5 years, they've lived it. They've spent sleepless nights worrying about rent checks, car payments, and student loans. They've made that long walk to the mailbox, running through the numbers to cover the next round of bills. And after checking homework, they've combed through job listings. This isn't new, it's daily life. But every morning, these men and women wake up with a determination and a purpose. Like all of life's best things, the pursuit of happiness isn't easy. That's something I learned growing up on the farm, and something Americans have always believed. That's why we don't give up. It's just not who we are. The American people haven't quit, and neither have Republicans. We're listening, and we're trying to help any way that we can. In the House, we've passed dozens of good, common sense jobs bills. And all of the above energy plan will get Americans back to work with immediate solutions like approving the Keystone Pipeline and moving forward with offshore energy production. The Skills Act rebuilds and updates our job training programs by cutting government overlap and equipping unemployed Americans with the tools they need. We've upended Washington's hurtful regulate first, ask later approach to red tape, and fought arbitrary regulations that restrict access to much-needed capital. We restored bipartisan welfare reform that helped millions of Americans trade government checks for paychecks. This is just a start. The House has passed dozens of jobs bills, many with bipartisan support. Each one would help Americans get the jobs they deserve. Unfortunately, all of these proposals are gathering dust in the Senate. President Obama's latest slogan is a year of action, but his administration and his party's leaders in the Senate are sitting on the bench. They seem to have surrendered to a new normal of high unemployment. Instead of standing shoulder to shoulder with out-of-work Americans, they're focused on making it easier to live without a job. They're focused on bigger government and less opportunity, more debt and fewer jobs. That might sound good in Washington, but back home, that's not the American dream folks are chasing. It's definitely not what an economic recovery looks like, and it's not something we have to settle for. Republicans hope the president is serious about making 2014 a year of action. It should start by giving each of these jobs bills an up or down vote in the Senate. Mr. President, the American people haven't backed down, and neither can we. Call on your party to give these jobs bills a vote. Let's keep the focus on employment, not unemployment. Let's do what Americans have always done and pull together towards better days and a more prosperous future. Thank you for listening.